Hey guys, welcome to Around the World. I'm Eric and in this video I'd like to show you around in the Cathedral Saint Michel and Saint Gudule here in Brussels. Follow me and let's go inside.
But first, let's take a look outside. In front of the impressive cathedral stands the statue of King Baudouin, who reigned as the fifth king of the Belgians from 1951 until his death in 1993. King Baudouin reigned for 42 years, but unfortunately died of a heart failure. His death came unexpected and sent much of Belgium into a period of deep mourning. The 24 hours of Spa sports cars race, which had reached the 15-hour mark at the time when the news broke, stopped immediately. Within hours, the royal palace gates and enclosure were covered with flowers that people brought spontaneously. Over 500,000 people, which is 5% of the total population, came to pay their respect when the viewing of the body was held at the royal palace. Many waited in line up till 14 hours in sweltering heat to see the king one last time. Luckily, there's no such lines here today. So if you'd still like to see his face, although it's in bronze now, you can go here. Let's move a little closer to the cathedral. It is built in many different stages. In the 9th century, it started as a chapel to honor St. Michael. However, two centuries later, Lambert II had a church built in its place. In 1047, the relics of St. Gudule were transported here, and thus the cathedral became of two patron saints, St. Michael and St. Gudule, and so did the city of Brussels. Two centuries later again, in the 13th century, two towers were added. This sounds like a well-planned and way overscheduled redecoration with small steps and adjustments, but the entire church took over 300 years to build. In 1962, the Roman Catholic Church was given the cathedral status. The cathedral is 114 meters in length, which is 374 feet, and 57 meters wide, which equals 187 feet. The height of the towers is 64 meters, or 210 feet if you like. Fun fact is that from April until May, there's a live webcam stream from one of the towers. This stream features a peregrine falcon family during their nestling cycle. From hatching of the nestlings to their first flight, everything is captured by the webcam and broadcasted in HD. Alright, time to go inside. That's why we're here for, after all. When entering the cathedral, take a few seconds to adjust to the different light conditions. And slowly you'll start to see so many beautiful details of this cathedral. At the sides of the aisle in front of you, statues of the 12 apostles can be seen attached to the columns. The pulpit by Hendrik Frans Verbrugge here on the right dates from the 17th century. The base represents Adam and Eve expelled from the Garden of Eden after plucking the forbidden fruit. At the top, the Virgin and Child piercing the serpent symbolize redemption. The big organ here in front of you was inaugurated in October 2000. It has 4,300 pipes, 63 stops, 4 manuals and 1 pedal. In short, that is even way lower and higher than Mariah Carey can sing. Left of the choir is the Chapel of the Blessed Sacrament of the Miracle. It now houses the treasures of the cathedral. Right of the choir is the Chapel of Our Lady of Deliverance, which is built in a late Gothic style and has a Baroque altar. Let's go there for a second. This is impressive, right? Although this is a place to be quiet and let your mind wander to nothing else but your prayer, I can't help the fact that I keep looking around by all the Baroque details that can be seen here. Baroque architecture is the building style of the Baroque era. Begun in the late 16th century in Italy, that took the Roman vocabulary of the Renaissance architecture and used it in a new rhetorical and theatrical fashion, often to express the triumph of the Catholic Church, says Wikipedia. Well, in short, that means Baroque is things with things and things. Just a whole lot of things, as you can see. And that's why it's so visually impressive. Behind the choir, there's another Baroque chapel. This chapel is dedicated to St. Mary Magdalene, dated 1685, with a marble and alabaster altarpiece depicting the Passion of Christ. The Cathedral St. Michael and St. Gudule plays a role in many important chapters of Belgium's history. Many kings were born, crowned and buried here. People who have visited the cathedral paint it as one of the most impressive cathedrals of Europe with beautiful stained glass and nice Gothic feeling. But the cathedral also carries a dark side, which is still depicted in its beautiful stained glass. In 1370, 6 Jews died on a stake because they stole sacramental hosts and cut them with daggers. the story goes that the sacramental host miraculously started to bleed. After being the center of discussion for decades, it took until 1977 before a bronze plate was placed warning the visitors of the cathedral of the anti-Semitic character of which the cathedral was the spectacle of for many centuries.
So that's it. I hope you liked the tour. Leave a comment down below what you like most about the cathedral, or let me know where you'd like to travel next. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more 360 travel videos. And as always, I'll see you around.